Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 6, Leçon A. And in this lesson, we'll discover together les démonstratifs. Les démonstratifs, so we'll see two types of démonstratifs. The first one will be adjectif, démonstratif, okay? And then the second one will be pronom démonstratif. All right, so let's start. So we'll see for the adjective démonstratif, the masculine singular form, feminine singular form, masculine plural form, and then feminine plural form. Okay, masculin singulier, féminin singulier, masculin pluriel, and then féminin pluriel. So let's see how they are. So when we talk about les démonstratifs, technically it would be translated in English like this. Okay, but then of course we've got in French the difference between the masculine and the feminine form, and then masculine plural and feminine plural. Okay, so we'll see them now. The first one, so for the masculine, so this, okay, adjective will be translated in French with ce, so it's the basic form, or cette. Okay, so you will have to use this second option here, this set, when you will have a name or a noun after that will start whether with a vowel or then with h plus a vowel. Okay, remember this h letter in French is not really pronounced. Okay, so it does indicate to you that when you get a word starting with the sound of a vowel, then you will have to use this set adjective. Okay, and then feminine form is cette, like that. So it's quite interesting because if you listen carefully, the masculine form here cette and the feminine form here cette, you write them differently but then you pronounce them the same way. All right, for the plural form, so masculine plural, it would be c'est. Okay, and then feminine plural, good news, it's the same. So we've got one form here, ce, and the option cette when you've got a noun starting with a vowel after, and then cette, feminine form, and for the plural you've got only one form, okay, and it's c'est. Okay, remember, open, c'est. Okay, one example, ce livre. So this book, okay, livre is book, here livre is masculine, so you will have to use the ce, okay, and then it doesn't start with the sound of a vowel, so it's the basic ce, this book, ce livre. And now we've got ordinateur. Ordinateur is a masculine word, means computer, okay, but then if you look carefully, it starts with o. Okay, a vowel. So this ce ordinateur wouldn't be possible. So we've got to use the second option, as we saw previously. So it's cet, written like that. Okay, cet ordinateur. This computer. Third possibility here, we've got homme, man. Okay, but then o is here. We've got this h letter, remember h is not pronounced, okay, so you've got the sound of o at the beginning of this word, okay, cet homme, so that's the reason why you will have to use the cet, so it's masculine but still cet homme. So now feminine word, femme, woman, no problem about that because we've got only one option for this at the feminine form, and it's cette, written like that. Cette femme. Same thing here, if you've got a word like organisation, well, it's the same in English. So it starts with a vowel, but it doesn't change anything for the feminine démonstratif here. Okay, cette organisation. Cette organisation. And then plural, so whether it's masculine, so we've got friends here at the masculine form, so masculine plural, and then friends here at the feminine plural form, okay, but then the adjective démonstratif here, as you can see, will be the same. Ses amis, ses amis. All right? And it's quite funny in a way, because if you only listen to these two things here, ses amis and then ses amis, you don't have really any phonetical information regarding the fact whether it's masculine or feminine. That's the way it is. Sorry about that. But so let's continue now with le démonstratif. So we'll see now the pronouns. Okay, so same thing. We'll see the masculin singulier, then féminin singulier, then masculin pluriel, and then féminin pluriel. Okay, so pronouns. Okay, so it does mean that you will have to use these pronouns instead of the name. Okay, so for the masculine form, we will have celui-ci and then celui-là. Okay, so we'll see the difference of use, but then celui-ci, celui-là. In English, it would be directly translated as this one. Okay, so you don't want to repeat the name or the thing that was previously stated, so you use this one. Okay. In English, it's easier. In French, it's a bit more tricky, because we will have this celui, okay? And then si and la. So you'll see that normally si is coming first and then la is coming next, okay? Celui-ci, celui-là, this one, all right? Same thing with the feminine form. Celle-ci, celle-là, all right? And then for the masculine plural, ceux-ci. Okay, remember, final X is not pronounced, so you get the sound ce, ceux-ci, and then ceux-là. All right, feminine plural, celles-ci. Okay, don't pronounce the final S, celles-ci, celles-là. All right, so let's see a few examples now. So if you ask a question, quel est mon livre? Okay, what is my book, or which one is my book? All right, and then the answer could be votre livre, your book, c'est celui-ci, this one. Okay, votre livre, c'est celui-ci. Okay, and then normally when you talk or when you say that, you tend to indicate that with your finger as well, so you point the book. Votre livre, c'est celui-ci. Où est ma place? Where is my seat? Où est ma place? C'est celle-là. Okay, same thing, you tend to point it at the same time. Okay, c'est celle-là. All right, so you've got to remember that we will have the difference between the masculine, the feminine. Okay, so singular and plural, and then we'll have the difference between this si, okay, the first option, the nearest one, okay, and then this la, second option, so it's not the nearest one. Okay, so let's see and practice. If it's okay with you, then you can go to the next lesson, and it's right here. Okay, the website is here, www.imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye bye. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 6, Leçon B. And in this lesson, we'll see together la description avec c'est. So let's start. So if you want to use this c'est option to make a description, so say technically would be directly translated as it is or this is, okay? But then in French, you will have to add after that the adjective, but the adjective should be all the time at the masculine form. Okay, so remember, if you want to describe something, okay, you can use this c'est. And that's really, you know, a common way to describe things. Okay, it is, this is, but then remember, the adjective that will come after should be at the masculine form. Okay, so we'll see a few examples now. And the first one would be the option to describe un lieu, a place. Okay, so let's see. Now, c'est chaud. Okay, it is hot. Warm, huh? Could be an option as well. C'est chaud, it's warm. Okay, c'est froid, cold. It is cold. C'est beau. Beau is beautiful. Okay, and then c'est tranquille, quiet. Okay, so what you can see here is that we've got adjectives like chaud, froid, beau, and then tranquille. They are all at the masculine form. Okay, even if, I mean, the place would be feminine and you want to describe it, remember that it should be all the time at the masculine form. Okay, let's see another example. So if you want to describe a situation, for instance, okay, it would be an option. So idéal, ideal, c'est idéal. Formidable. C'est parfait. So it's perfect. And then c'est injuste, the opposite is of juste, okay, and it's not fair, unfair, okay. So c'est idéal, c'est formidable, c'est parfait, c'est injuste. Same thing here, okay, remember that all these adjectives are at the feminine form. Okay, let's continue now and see. So it could be for an object as well. You could describe an objet. So let's see now. C'est cher. Cher is expensive. C'est cher. C'est utile. Utile, useful. C'est beau. Beautiful. C'est adapté. Adapted. Okay? C'est cher. C'est utile. C'est beau. C'est adapté. Remember, all these adjectives are at the masculine form. I'm getting tired now. All right, so at the masculine form, like I did say previously. Okay, so let's see now another option. So if you want to describe a dish, okay, you're eating and you want to describe a dish, un plat, okay. So, c'est très bon. Okay, très is very, and then bon is good. Okay, c'est très bon. C'est bon marché. Bon marché, it's actually quite interesting. I mean, this adjective here, so it's a composed adjective, and it means cheap. Okay, c'est bon marché. C'est salé. So remember, it's quite important because we've got the same adjective here without the accent. So if you don't put the accent, it means dirty, and then you pronounce it sale. But in that case here, okay, you put the accent, and it's quite important because in that case it means salted, okay? Salé, okay? C'est salé. C'est délicieux. C'est délicieux, okay? And then same thing here, if you look all these adjectives, they are at the masculine form, okay? So the second option would be to put this structure at the negative form, which is not that difficult because technically you just keep, well, your structure, you just add as usual the first ne and then pas before and after the verb, okay? Then same thing here, you will put this adjective at the masculine form, okay? So we will basically just see one more time all the examples we had previously, but then at the negative form. So if you want to describe a place, ce n'est pas chaud, ce n'est pas froid, ce n'est pas beau, ce n'est pas tranquille. Situation, ce n'est pas idéal, ce n'est pas formidable. Ce n'est pas parfait. Ce n'est pas injuste. An object. Ce n'est pas cher. Ce n'est pas utile. Ce n'est pas beau. Ce n'est pas adapté. And then a dish. Ce n'est pas très bon. Ce n'est pas bon marché. Ce n'est pas salé. Ce n'est pas délicieux. All right, that was it. Check for the next lesson. It's on youtube.com/imagier and then the website is here. www.imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye bye. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 6, Leçon C. And in this lesson, we'll work on the vocabulary regarding la salle de séjour. So let's start now. Le rideau. Le fauteuil. So remember, it's a bit tricky, this word. Fauteuil. Teuil. Fauteuil. Le fauteuil. Le coussin. La cheminée. La télévision. Ok, one more time. Le rideau. Le fauteuil. Le coussin. La cheminée. La télévision. Le lecteur DVD. Le lecteur de CD. La table basse. Le lustre. Le cendrier. Ok, one more time. Le lecteur DVD. Le lecteur de CD. La table basse. Le lustre. Le cendrier. Le sol. La table. Le tapis. Le canapé. La bibliothèque. One more time. Le sol. La table. Le tapis. Remember, final S not pronounced. Le tapis. Le canapé. La bibliothèque. That's it for la salle de séjour. Okay? If you want more, then it's here and then the website is right here. Have a great day. Bye bye. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. And this is Unité 6, Leçon D. And in this lesson, we'll go into la cuisine. So in the previous lesson, we were in la salle de séjour. And now we're still in the house, but it's la cuisine. So let's discover what we have. La cuisine. Le congélateur. Le réfrigérateur, le frigo. L'évier. L'étagère. Ok, so let's repeat them. La cuisine. Le congélateur. Le réfrigérateur. Le frigo. L'évier. L'étagère. L'égouttoir. L'armoire murale. Le four. La cuisinière. Le lave-vaisselle. Ok, let's see them one more time. L'égouttoir. L'armoire murale. Le four. La cuisinière. Le lave-vaisselle. Le chauffe-eau. La théière. La cafetière. La louche. L'entonnoir. Okay, let's see them one more time. Le chauffe-eau, la théière, la cafetière, la louche, l'entonnoir. Le décapsuleur, l'ouvre-boîte, le tire-bouchon, le presse-citron, la passoire. All right, let's repeat them together. Le décapsuleur, l'ouvre-boîte, le tire-bouchon, le presse-citron, la passoire. La râpe, le couteau, le casse-noix, le hachoir, le rouleau à pâtisserie. Ok, let's see them. La râpe, le couteau, le casse-noix, le hachoir, le rouleau à pâtisserie. That's it. You've got many, many, many words. So I hope you remember them. If that's not the case, well, try to watch the video one more time. And then if you want more, then it's here. And the website, oops, is here. And that's imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 6, Leçon E. Okay, and it's a quite important lesson because we'll see vocabulary and we'll see les fruits et légumes, so fruits and vegetables. So I hope you're ready because we are starting right now. Les fruits. L'orange. So I did put this little F just to indicate you that it's feminine. Okay, l'orange. La pomme, la pêche, le melon. Okay, so les fruits, l'orange, la pomme, la pêche, le melon. L'ananas, le pamplemousse, la pastèque, la banane, la figue. All right. L'ananas, le pamplemousse, la pastèque, la banane, la figue. La prune, la mandarine, le citron, l'abricot, la cerise, la prune, la mandarine, le citron, l'abricot. So by the way, I didn't put it, but it's masculine, just for your information. La cerise, la poire, le raisin, le marron, la date, la poire, le raisin, le marron, la date, les baies, la fraise, la framboise, la groseille à maquereau, la groseille rouge. I just noticed that I've been making a little mistake here. Sorry about that. Les baies, la fraise, la framboise, la groseille à maquereau, La groseille rouge. La myrtille. La mûre des marais. La canneberge. Le cassis. L'airelle rouge. La myrtille. La mûre des marais. La canneberge. Le cassis. L'airelle rouge. La courgette. Le haricot vert. Le concombre. La salade. La carotte. La courgette. Le haricot vert. Le concombre. La salade. La carotte. L'asperge. Le navet. Le petit pois. L'ail. La lentille. L'asperge. Le navet. Le petit pois. L'ail. La lentille. Le haricot. La fève. L'artichaut. L'oignon. Le chou. Le haricot. La fève. L'artichaut. So for your information, artichaut is masculine. L'oignon. Same thing for onion, it's masculine. Le chou. La tomate. Le chou-fleur. La pomme de terre. Le poivron. L'aubergine. La tomate. Le chou-fleur. La pomme de terre. Le poivron. L'aubergine. For your information, aubergine is a feminine word. L'épinard. Le fenouil. Le champignon. L'épinard. So it's masculine. Le fenouil. Le champignon. That's it, and you do have many, many words to remember. Especially, they are quite useful. I mean, you're talking quite often, I think, about vegetables or food in general, fruits. So if you're not sure, if you want to review this video or to watch it again, don't be afraid. And then if you want to continue, then the next lesson is here. And the website is here. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Bonjour à tous. Hi, everyone, and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 6, Leçon F. And in this lesson, we'll discover together les comparatifs. So if you want to compare in French, well, this is the lesson you should definitely watch. So in this structure, in this lesson, sorry, we'll discover three type of structures. The first one, avec un nom, with a noun. Second one, avec un adjectif, with an adjective. And the last one, avec un verbe, with a verb. Okay, so if you want to compare with these structures, then we'll start with the first one, avec un nom. Okay, so if you want to compare with a noun, then remember that if you want to say more, then you will have to use this plus, de, and then here, you will put your noun, after that followed by que, than, and the rest of the structure. Okay, let's see one example. J'ai plus de chance que vous. J'ai plus de chance que vous. Okay, chance is luck. Okay, j'ai plus de chance que vous. Vous is you. Alright? Il a plus d'amis que moi. Il a plus d'amis que moi. Amis, friends. Nous avons plus de livres que. Nous avons plus de livres que. Okay, so if I want to be really honest, and I will be, there is a strange thing in French language with this plus. Okay, because in some cases you will have to pronounce the final S, and in other cases you won't. So what I would advise you to do, because we are at a beginning stage, it would be to pronounce it each time, especially with this type of structure. So if you want to construct it followed by a noun, then in that case my advice would be pronounce it. Okay, after that, if you get the chance to go in French-speaking countries or meet French-speaking persons, then you can listen to them and you will learn how to use it or not. Okay, but the first advice would be, if you're using this kind of structure with nouns, then pronounce it. Okay, so let's see now if you want to say as. Okay, so if you want to compare, so it would be autant de, followed by the noun, then with this que, then, and you continue your structure, okay? J'ai autant de chance que vous. Okay, so I kept exactly the same sentences, just to make it more clear, okay? J'ai autant de chance que vous. Il a autant d'amis que moi. Il a autant d'amis que moi. Okay, so as usual in French, you know, you've got this de here, but then if the word, you know, coming right after is starting with a vowel or sh plus a vowel, then you should definitely take this e away, okay? Il a autant d'amis que moi. Nous avons autant de livres que, okay? And then same thing here, as you can see here, you've got this que. Okay, but then followed by a vowel, in that case, a needs to go away, and then you get this que. Alright. Then if you want to say less, it's moins in French, so no discussion about the S here, don't pronounce it, okay? Moins de, and then you put your noun, que, than, and the rest of the structure. So let's see. J'ai moins de chance que vous. J'ai moins de chance que vous. Il a moins d'amis que moi. Il a moins d'amis que moi. Nous avons moins de livres que. Nous avons moins de livres que. Alright, so that's it. Now let's see if you want to compare and use a structure with an adjective. Donc avec un adjectif, okay, first structure, if you want to use this more, okay, so you will use this plus, and in that case you don't pronounce the S, okay, plus, then you put your adjective, and after that you put this que, then, and the rest of the sentence, okay, so let's see now. Elle est plus rapide que moi. Rapid is fast, okay. Elle est plus rapide que moi. Il est plus fort que son frère. Fort is strong. Il est plus fort que son frère. Nous sommes plus intéressés que vous. Okay, and in that case, well, you make this little link, little liaison between the two, so you hear a little bit this S, okay? Nous sommes plus intéressés que vous. Alright, so let's see them one more time. Elle est plus rapide que moi. Il est plus fort que son frère. Nous sommes plus intéressés que vous. Alright? And then, aussi, then you put your adjective, que, then, and the rest of the sentence. Okay, so, the same examples. Elle est aussi rapide que moi. Il est aussi fort que son frère. Nous sommes aussi intéressés que vous. Okay, so I'll repeat them. Elle est aussi rapide que moi. Il est aussi fort que son frère. Nous sommes aussi intéressés que vous. Alright. And then, moins, Same thing here. Remember, we don't pronounce the final S. Then you put the adjective que, then, and the rest of the sentence. Okay? Elle est moins rapide que moi. Il est moins fort que son frère. Nous sommes moins intéressés que vous. Okay, one more time. Elle est moins rapide que moi. Il est moins fort que son frère. Nous sommes moins intéressés que vous. Alright. And so the last structure, if you want to compare with a verb, then, in that case, remember, plus will be with the S. So pronounce it plus que. Okay, let's see now. Elle parle plus que toi. Elle parle plus que toi. Il mange plus que son frère. Il mange plus que son frère. Nous voyageons plus que vous. Nous voyageons plus que vous. Okay, so let's repeat them. Elle parle plus que toi. Il mange plus que son frère. Nous voyageons plus que vous. And then, autant que. Alright? So it goes like, elle parle autant que toi. Il mange autant que son frère. Nous voyageons autant que vous. Alright, so let's repeat them one more time. Elle parle autant que toi. Il mange autant que son frère. Nous voyageons autant que vous. And the last one. Moins que. Elle parle moins que toi. Il mange moins que son frère. Nous voyageons moins que vous. One more time. Elle parle moins que toi. Il mange moins que son frère. Nous voyageons moins que vous. And this is it. Okay, the next lesson is here on YouTube/imagier. And then the website is here, imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye bye. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 6, Leçon G. And in this lesson, we'll see together, let me click, le passé composé of the verb faire. Faire is to do, and then we'll see together the passé composé form. So we did introduce the passé composé in the unit 5, okay, but I just want to check and make it clear that everything is okay for you. So we'll start with faire. It will be quite fast, but still quite useful. Let's start. J'ai fait. Tu as fait. Il a fait. Elle a fait. Nous avons fait. Vous avez fait. Ils ont fait. Elles ont fait. Alright, so to make it clear, one more time, remember that in most of the cases for the passé composé, you will have to use avoir at the present form, followed by this participe passé form. So if you're not sure how to construct that, check Unité 5, and then you will see the lesson that explains everything, okay? But then we'll repeat it one more time. J'ai fait. So remember, final T is not pronounced. J'ai fait. Tu as fait. Il a fait. Elle a fait. Nous avons fait. Little link between the two. Nous avons. Nous avons fait. Same thing here. Vous avez fait. And same thing here. Ils ont. Ils ont fait. Elles ont fait. Alright? So that's it. It was the verb faire at the passé composé. Really important. If that's okay with you and if it's clear, then you can continue. And the website is youtube.com/imagier. Or then more material, imagier.net. Have a great day. Au revoir. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 6, Leçon H. And in this lesson, we'll continue our little review of le passé composé. Well, basically, it's for important verbs, and this one, venir, to come, is quite important, especially because it's a bit tricky in a way. So we'll see why. Je suis venu. Tu es venu. Il est venu. Elle est venue. Nous sommes venus. Vous êtes venus. Ils sont venus. Elles sont venues. Okay, so if you remember carefully when we introduced the passé composé construction in the Unit 5, I told you that most of the verbs were constructed with avoir, but then we had the list of the verbs that requires this être verb. Venir is among them, okay? So that's the reason why you put être here at the present form, okay? And then remember that if you get to put être, then have a look at the feminine form here. You will have to add this final e, okay, feminine singular. But then for the plural form, you will have to add this S here, here, okay? And then for the feminine plural, you will have to add this ES. All right, but then the good news, there is a good news, yes. It's that you don't pronounce them. So basically, you get the pronunciation venu, venu, venu. And then the same thing, venu, you don't pronounce this final E. Venu, you don't pronounce the final S. Venu, you don't pronounce it, the final S either. Same thing here, venu. And same thing here, venu, you don't pronounce S. So phonetically, you only have one way to pronounce it. But remember, if you want to write correctly, you will have to put E for the feminine, S for the plural, ES for the feminine plural. Okay, let's repeat them one more time. Je suis venu. Tu es venu. Il est venu. Elle est venue. Nous sommes venus. Vous êtes venus. Ils sont venus. Elles sont venues. That's it. Okay. Well, the next lesson is here. And then the website imagier.net is waiting for you. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 6, Leçon I. And we are continuing our things regarding le passé composé. So we'll see together le passé composé form of pouvoir, pouvoir, can. And then we'll see how it goes at the past form, this passé composé form. Okay, so j'ai pu, tu as pu. Il a pu, elle a pu, nous avons pu, vous avez pu, ils ont pu, elles ont pu. Okay, so if you remember carefully, as I said, in Unit 5, when I introduced this passé composé form, most of the verbs are using avoir at the present form, so that's the case here. And then after that, you've got to put the participe passé. Same thing, it was introduced in Unit 5, so check it if you want. And then for pouvoir, it's a bit tricky because pouvoir becomes pu like that. Only two letters, okay? But then it doesn't change. If you look carefully, then it's always the same form. Okay, so let's see them together. J'ai pu. Tu as pu. Remember, you don't pronounce the S here. Il a pu. Elle a pu. Nous avons pu. Little link, little liaison between the two. Nous avons pu. Vous avez pu. Same thing here. Little liaison between the two. Ils ont pu. Same thing here. Elles ont pu. Alright? So that's it. It was quite short but quite important. Okay? So if you want to check for the next lesson, it's here. And then the website is waiting for you. Imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye bye. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. It's Unité 6, Leçon J. I was not sure about that, but still it's written on the screen. Unité 6, Leçon J. And in this lesson, we'll discover together le passé composé. And the verb is attendre. Attendre is to wait. Okay, and so we'll see the past form. So it's just some reviews that we are doing, but they are really important. So let's see how it goes now. J'ai attendu. Tu as attendu. Il a attendu. Elle a attendu. Nous avons attendu. Vous avez attendu. Ils ont attendu. Elles ont attendu. Alright, so if you remember, when I introduced the passé composé form, I told you that most of the verbs are using this avoir verb at the present form and then the participe passé. Okay, in that case, attendre becomes attendu at the participe passé, and then that's the form you will have to add at the end, and it doesn't change here, as you can see. J'ai attendu, tu as attendu, il a attendu, elle a attendu, nous avons attendu, so two liaisons here, nous avons attendu, nous avons attendu. Vous avez attendu, same thing here, vous avez attendu, okay, vous avez attendu, then same thing here, ils ont attendu, okay, liaison here as well, ils ont attendu, okay, but make it fast, ils ont attendu, elles ont attendu. That's it for attendre at the passé composé form. If you want to check for the next lesson, it's right here. And then the website is here, imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye bye. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. And it's Unité 6, Leçon K. And in this lesson, we'll see together le passé composé of répondre. Répondre is to answer and it's quite useful. So let's see how it goes for the passé composé form. J'ai répondu. Tu as répondu. Il a répondu. Elle a répondu. Nous avons répondu. Vous avez répondu. Ils ont répondu. Elles ont répondu. Alright, so it's not that difficult. Keep in mind that répondre, so the infinitive form, becomes répondu at the participe passé form. Okay, so this form that you will have to add each time here doesn't change. You know, you don't put the the feminine form or the plural form. You just keep it like that. Okay, so let's see them one more time. J'ai répondu. Tu as répondu. Il a répondu. Elle a répondu. Nous avons répondu. Vous avez répondu. Ils ont répondu. Elles ont répondu. OK? Easy! C'est facile, n'est-ce pas? OK, so if that's clear for you, then check the website youtube.com/imagier and then you can find the next lesson. And then the website is here, imagier.net, and it's waiting for you. OK, bye-bye. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 6, Leçon L. And in this lesson, we'll see together again le passé composé, but this time it will be for the verb partir. Partir is to leave. Okay? And then you'll see that it goes like that. Je suis parti. Tu es parti. Il est parti. Elle est partie. Nous sommes partis. Vous êtes partis. Ils sont partis. Elles sont parties. Okay? Remember, partir belongs to this group of verbs that requires to use être instead of avoir for the passé composé form. And for that reason, you will have here, for example, when you've got the feminine form, you will have to put this final E at the end of your participe passé form. Okay? If that's plural, like it is here, you will have to add S. Okay? And if it's feminine plural, you will have to add this E, S at the end of your participe passé form. But when it comes to phonetics, so what you will pronounce, the good news is that you won't pronounce these E, S, or E, S. Okay, so it will go like parti, parti, and then here, same thing, parti, parti, and parti. Okay, so phonetically it's not that difficult, but then if you want to write correctly, remember to put E for the feminine form, S for the plural form, E, S for the feminine plural form. Okay, so let's see that together. Je suis parti, tu es parti, il est parti, elle est partie, nous sommes partis, vous êtes partis, ils sont partis, elles sont parties. Ok, that's it. YouTube.com/imagier. Next lesson is waiting for you. And then the website is here, www.imagier.net. Au revoir. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 6, Leçon M. And in this lesson, we'll discover together le passé composé of the verb savoir. Savoir is to know. It's quite used and quite useful. Okay? But then keep in mind that this lesson regarding passé composé is the last one. Okay? So if you're not sure how to make it, remember that in Unit 5, I did a big lesson regarding le passé composé. And then in Unit 6, few verbs were, it was possible to see them, okay? But then after that, we won't see le passé composé again. All right, so let's start now. Le passé composé, savoir, goes like, j'ai su. Tu as su. Il a su. Elle a su. Nous avons su. Vous avez su. Ils ont su. Elles ont su. Alright, so for the last time, in most of the cases for the verbs, we will use avoir and then we'll use the participe passé form. In that case, savoir becomes su. Okay, so that's the reason why that's the form that you will see at the end of each forms here, okay, and then avoir should be at the present form, alright? J'ai su, tu as su, il a su, elle a su, nous avons su, vous avez su, ils ont su, elles ont su. That's it for le passé composé. So now, if you want to see something new, then youtube.com/imagier is waiting for you and then the website is here. Au revoir. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 6, Leçon N. And in this lesson we'll discover together something really important and that's what we call le futur simple. So basically it's the future tense, okay? When you want to express something that you will do. Let's see how we will make it in French. So, we'll see the difference between the three groups of verbs that we've got in French. The first one, first group, is ending with ER. Remember, parler, to talk, to speak. So, the idea is that in that case, for this group, you don't change anything. So, you just keep the basic form, the infinitive form, all right? And after that, you will put at the end a e for je. Okay, so this will be your ending. So you just don't touch the verb, don't touch the infinitive form, you just put at the end this ending. Okay? Second group of verbs, finir, to finish, to end. Well, the good news is that it will behave the same way as for the first group of verb. You don't modify anything. You just keep your infinitive form and you will put the ending AE here as well. So you get je parlerai and then you will get je finirai. So it's not that difficult for these two first group. Okay? The third group, it's a bit more tricky, of course, as usual, because we're talking about irregular verbs. Okay? But still, I took this lire. Lire is to read. Okay? And then you can see that it's ending with this so the vowel, okay? As usual, what we'll do, we'll take this E away. So we get now L-I-R, and after that, we just put the ending. Je lirai. Alright, so it will apply for most of the verbs. Of course, because it's French language, it's not all the verbs. We've got exceptions, but we'll see the exceptions a bit later in this lesson. But still, that's the idea of constructing it. If it's ending with this vowel, take it away. Alright, you get that. And after that, you just put the ending. Alright, so let's see. The ending for je will be AI. Alright, and you pronounce it A. Remember, open A. Okay? The ending for tu will be AS. You don't pronounce the S, so you pronounce A. Alright? The ending for il, elle, will be A. Okay? Phonetically, exactly the same thing as for tu. Okay? A, A. The ending for nous will be ONS. As usual, okay, remember, you don't pronounce the final S, you get the on sound, okay, nasal in your nose, on, on, alright? The ending for vous will be, as usual, a Z, but then you pronounce it E, okay? And then the ending for il, elle, will be O, N, T, you don't pronounce the final T, so you get the nasal on, alright? So, E, A, A, on, et, on. Okay? So let's see how it will go with parler, parler, to speak, to talk. Okay? Je parlerai. Tu parleras. Il parlera. Elle parlera. Nous parlerons. Vous parlerez. Ils parleront. Elles parleront. Alright, so as I said, just keep your basic form and just put your endings, okay, e, a, a, on, et, on, that's it. Let's see now, choisir, to choose, second group of verbs, je choisirai, tu choisiras, il choisira, elle choisira, nous choisirons, vous choisirez, ils choisiront, elles choisiront. Same thing, remember, just keep the infinitive form, the basic form, and just put your endings at the end. E, A, A, on, et, on. Okay? Let's see now, écrire, écrire is to write, okay? So, third group, but then remember, as we saw with lire, lire, we took away this final E, okay? And only with the first part, we just add after that the endings. So, j'écrirai, tu écriras, il écrira, elle écrira, nous écrirons, vous écrirez, ils écriront, elles écriront. Alright, so it's not that difficult, okay, as I said, you take away the E, and after that, E, A, A, on, et, on. Alright? So, of course, we've got some exceptions, as I said. The first one is être. Être will become sœur. So the important thing with the futur simple is that the verb will change, but the endings will be the same. Okay, so the endings we saw previously will be exactly the same. Okay, so the only thing that you've got to remember is that être will become sœur. So that's the part that you will first, you will have to put, and then you will combine it with the ending, and it will become je serai. Okay, remember, ending for je was AI, je serai. Okay, avoir is becoming or. Okay, so tu auras. Aller will become ir. Il ira, elle ira. Faire will become faire, F-E-R. So you will get nous ferons. savoir will become sort, S-A-U-R. Vous saurez. Voir will become ver. Ils verront, elles verront. All right, so remember, être is becoming sœur, avoir becomes or, aller, ir, faire, feur, savoir, sort, voir, vers. Okay, but then after all these forms, you will just put the normal endings that we saw previously. So, A-I for je, A-S for A, A, O-N-S, E-Z, O-N-T. Other exceptions. Pouvoir will become pour. Je pourrais. Vouloir, voudre. Tu voudras. Pleuvoir, pleuvre. Il pleuvra. Devoir, d'œuvre. Nous devrons. Venir, viendre. Vous viendrez. Courir, cours. Ils, elles courront. Okay, so pouvoir is becoming pour, and it means can. Vouloir, voudre, to want. Pleuvoir, to rain, pleuvre. Devoir, to have to, d'œuvre. Venir, to come, viendre. Courir, to run, cours. Okay, and then as we saw previously, you only add after the endings. All right, so remember one more time, je ending for je is AI. Tu ending for tu is AS. Il, elle, A. Nous, O-N-S. Vous, E-Z. Il, elle, O-N-T. Okay, so est, a, on, et, on. That's it. Now you can construct un futur simple. Congratulations. The next lesson is here, youtube.com/imagier, and that the website is waiting for you, imagier.net. Au revoir. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 6, Leçon O. And in this lesson, we'll discover together le pronom complément en. So let's see now. We can use this pronom complément en, whether with an article partitif, so this some concept, or then it can be an article indéfini, a. In English, it would be a, un, une, or then it can be at the negative form. So that's what we'll see, and then we'll start first with l'article partitif. Okay, so let's see now how we can make it. So if you have a question like Nicolas mange du pain, so of course, first possibility that you could have would be to answer oui, Nicolas mange du pain. So mange is to eat, du pain, some bread. Okay, in that case, that's really the partitive form. Okay, so you don't want to specify the quantity, but it's some. Okay, so of course, the first option that you would have would be to answer like that. Oui, Nicolas mange du pain. So you repeat everything. Normally, that's not the way we will do, because we tend to replace things with pronouns when it's possible. Okay, so the first option would be to replace Nicolas in that case. You don't want to repeat Nicolas, so you can say oui, il, he, instead of Nicolas because it's masculine, mange du pain. So that's the first step. Okay, the second step, you want to replace this du pain. Okay, so this partitive thing. And that's when this pronoun en is used. All right? So, oui, il en mange. Okay? So in that case, you use this il just to avoid repeating Nicolas because it was previously stated. And then you want to use this en, the pronoun, just to avoid repeating Dupin because it was in the question. Okay? Oui, il en mange. So remember that this en pronoun should be before the verb. Okay? So let's see now another example. In the first example, we had the masculine form, and now I wrote same sentence, but then here we've got de la salade. Okay, salade is feminine word, so in that case it's not du, but then it's de la, okay, but still it's the partitive form, some, okay. Nicolas mange de la salade, okay, so as we saw, first option would be oui, Nicolas mange de la salade, so you repeat the whole sentence. Second option, you don't want to repeat Nicolas, oui, il mange de la salade, okay. And the last option, you don't want to repeat either Nicolas nor de la salade, so you get oui, il en mange. Okay, let's see now if you've got de l'eau. Nicolas boit de l'eau. Oui, Nicolas boit de l'eau. Second option, you don't want to repeat Nicolas. Oui, il boit de l'eau. Third option, oui, il en boit. Okay, same rule, en goes before the verb. Boit, here, it's the infinitive form is boire and it's to drink. Okay, de l'eau, some water. D'accord? Okay, let's continue now. Second structure, if you want to use le pronom en instead of an article indéfini. So let's see how it goes. In that case, you know, you've got a question. Nicolas mange un biscuit. So it's quite interesting because the difference between what we had previously with the this partitif, some, when you use this partitive form, you don't really give any information regarding the quantity. In that case, you use un, so that's clear, it's only one. Okay? Nicolas mange un biscuit. First answer, oui, Nicolas mange un biscuit. Same thing as previously, you just put everything again. Second possibility, you don't want to repeat Nicolas. Oui, il mange un biscuit. All right. Last option, you don't want to repeat Nicolas and you don't want to repeat biscuit. Okay. The difference here between what we saw with the partitif and now is that you've got the here you've got the quantity, so you know exactly how many or how much. Okay. So you get to put that at the end of your sentence. Oui, il en. So you put your pronoun here before the verb. And after that, you put un. Il en mange un. All right? So let's see now if it's feminine. Une banane. Nicolas mange une banane? Answer. Oui, Nicolas mange une banane. Oui, il mange une banane. Oui, il en mange une. Okay, so the information that you've got now is that you will have to put the masculine or the feminine form after. Okay, here you put une because banane is a feminine word. All right? So let's see now. Nicolas mange des céréales. So here we've got the plural form. Oui, Nicolas mange des céréales. Oui, il mange des céréales. Oui, il en mange. All right? So, basically, when you've got the plural form for des céréales here, you don't put anything after your verb. All right? So, when you use this article indéfini, you will only need to put something after your verb if it's un or une. Or then in other cases, but we will come to that a bit later, okay? So, let's see now la forme négative. Nicolas ne mange pas de céréales, Okay, so you've got the question, but here you've got the ne and then the pas, so you know that it's négatif. Nicolas ne boit pas d'eau. So let's see the answers. Non, il n'en mange pas. Non, il n'en boit pas. Okay, so the concept is still the same. You put your pronoun here and here before your verb. And then, as usual in French, normally you should have your ne coming here. But then, look, the pronoun is starting with a vowel, starting with e. Okay, so you should take this e away. All right. Il n'en mange pas. Il n'en boit pas. All right? And then, le pronom en, well, it can replace the preposition de plus a noun, and especially a noun for a thing. Okay, so let's see now. Est-ce que Frédéric est content de son nouvel ordinateur? Okay, est-ce que Frédéric est content? Content is to be happy, satisfied, okay, de son nouvel new ordinateur, computer. D'accord? Est-ce que Frédéric est content de son nouvel ordinateur? Alright, so it's exactly the same concept. You could answer, I mean, you could make a long answer reusing every object or everything in the question. But then, in that case, we'll try to go a bit faster. And so we don't want, of course, to repeat de son nouvel ordinateur here. Okay, so the concept is that we will use this pronoun en instead. Oui, il, en, est content. Alright, so en, same thing here, before the verb. And then after that, of course, you continue your sentence because satisfied should be in the answer. Okay, so oui, il en est content. Negative form, non, il n'en est pas content. So same thing, en stays before the verb, and then you've got the first part of the negation, ne, but then e is going away. All right? Oui, il en est content. Non, il n'en est pas content. Est-ce que Frédéric parle de son chef? Oui, il en parle. Non, il n'en parle pas. Okay, so same thing, same concept, just put it before the verb, okay? When you've got the negative form, then you should take this e away from the first part of your negative form. Il n'en parle pas. Est-ce que Frédéric a besoin de notre aide? Okay, avoir besoin, it's to need, okay? Notre aide, our help. Est-ce que Frédéric a besoin de notre aide? Same thing here. We don't want to repeat de notre aide. So, oui, il en a besoin. Non, il n'en a pas besoin. All right? And now, let's see how it goes when you constructed with one verb, avec un verbe, with two verbs, avec deux verbes. And then if you construct it with one verb composed, like for the passé composé, for instance. So let's see now, avec un verbe, with one verb. So you've got a question. Laurent prend un biscuit. Oui, il en prend un. Non, il n'en prend pas. So remember, we saw that previously, huh? If you've got un biscuit, in that case you've got to state the amount here, un, okay, so in that case it's masculine, un biscuit, so it's un. Oui, il en prend un, okay, so you put en before the first verb. Non, il n'en prend pas. Laurent prend deux biscuits. Oui, il en prend deux. Okay, so in that case, you've got to put the amount. Il en prend deux. So it would be the same if you would have trois biscuits, three. In that case, you would put oui, il en prend trois. But then keep in mind that if you put the negative answer, non, il n'en prend pas. So you don't need to state the amount, okay? Il n'en prend pas. Now, we'll see the same structures, but with two verbs. And so, the best way to construct with two verbs, if you want to make examples like that, is to construct that with the near future. Laurent va prendre un biscuit. He's going to take a biscuit. Laurent va prendre un biscuit. Oui, il va en prendre un. So the interesting thing here is that if you look carefully, you've got first aller here. So the first verb is here. And then you've got the second verb here. So it's at the infinitive form because that's the rule in French. When you construct with two verbs, the second one will be at the infinitive. And keep in mind that your pronoun, en here, should be before the second verb. Okay, so I'm not going to tell you that it should be between the two because you could have other things between the two. Okay, it should be before the second verb. Oui, il va en prendre un. Okay, and you get a good example here for the reason why I told you it should be before. Non, il ne va pas en prendre. Alright, because here you've got your aller verb, va, but then you've got the negative form, ne va pas. But then your pronoun should be before the second one. Okay? Il ne va pas en prendre. Let's see now. Laurent va prendre deux biscuits. Answer. Oui, il va en prendre deux. Non, il ne va pas en prendre. Okay? So let's see now when you've got a composed verb. So, we just need to put the same sentence at the passé composé form. Laurent a pris un biscuit. Oui, il en a pris un. Okay? So, the important thing now is to try to remember that when you've got this form, a pris, even if you've got two parts, well, technically you don't have two verbs, you've got one verb. Okay, so your pronoun en should be before the verb, so it means before a here. Okay, one common mistake is to put this en between the two. Okay, because you tend to think that maybe you've got two verbs, but no. It's here, okay, il en a pris un. Negative form, il n'en a pas pris. Alright? Non, il n'en a pas pris. Laurent a pris deux biscuits. Oui, il en a pris deux. Non, il n'en a pas pris. And that's it for le pronom en. I know it's a bit difficult, but then it's quite important because French people or French-speaking people tend to use quite often these pronouns, especially when they talk, so it's important to know them. It's normal that maybe at the beginning you won't be able to produce it, I mean to make sentences with all these pronouns, but still it's really important to know them and to understand them. Okay, so that's it. The next lesson is here, youtube.com/imagier, and the website is waiting for you, imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye bye. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 6, Leçon P, and it's the last lesson for Unité 6. And in this lesson, we'll see together le pronom complément Y. So in the previous lesson, we saw another pronoun. So it's the pronoun en, okay? And in that case, in this lesson, we'll see le pronom Y. Well, you pronounce it I, of course. So, le pronom Y, we'll say that it can replace un lieu, a place, okay? Or then it can replace la préposition à, and then a noun of thing. And then we'll see how to construct it when you get a negative form, okay? So let's see now for a place, un lieu. So let's see a question. Isabelle va en Finlande. So va, remember, it's aller, okay? And then en Finlande, in Finland. Isabelle va en Finlande. So of course, you will have many options to answer to this question. The first one would be maybe the more logical. Oui, Isabelle va en Finlande. So you just take all the elements that you had in the question and then you answer with that. Of course, in many situations, we won't, because French people like to use pronouns when it's possible. So the first option that we would have is to avoid repeating Isabelle, okay? So, elle va en Finlande, all right? And the other option we would have would be to avoid repeating this en Finlande, okay? So it's a place, it's a country, okay? And in that case, it does mean that it would be possible to use this Y, so I, you pronounce it I, okay? So, oui, elle y va. So keep in mind that it's a pronoun and then it should be here just before your verb, okay? Elle y va. All right, so oui, Isabelle va en Finlande. Oui, elle va en Finlande. Oui, elle y va. Okay, so let's see another example now. So if you're using a name of a town, because previously we had a country and now it's a town, so it's Paris, okay? Isabelle va à Paris? So it's a question. Of course, you can answer like we saw previously. Oui, Isabelle va à Paris. First option, repeat everything, no problem. Second option, you just want to avoid repeating Isabelle. Oui, elle va à Paris. And then, last option, you just want to avoid repeating Isabelle and then Paris. Oui, elle y va. All right. And now it's a place. Cinéma. Okay. Isabelle est au cinéma? Oui. Isabelle est au cinéma. Repeat everything. Second one, you just don't want to repeat Isabelle. Oui. Elle est au cinéma. All right. Third one, just want to avoid repeating Isabelle and au cinéma. Oui. Elle y est. All right. Oui, Isabelle est au cinéma. Oui, elle est au cinéma. Oui, elle y est. Second situation, when we can use this pronoun I or Y, it's when you replace it. When you replace this preposition A and then a noun of thing. Let's see now. Est-ce qu'Isabelle pense, pense is to think, à son examen, exam, okay, to think about. Est-ce qu'Isabelle pense à son examen? First option, repeat everything. Oui, Isabelle pense à son examen. Second option, you just don't repeat Isabelle. Oui, elle pense à son examen. Third option, you don't repeat Isabelle. And same thing for à son examen, so oui, elle y pense. All right, same concept, remember, I should come before the verb. Est-ce qu'Isabelle joue au tennis? So in that case, remember, it's O, but then O is clearly the combination of the preposition A and then the article le tennis, the, okay? So when you combine these two, you get this au tennis. So still, it does give you the information that it is the preposition which is modified. So still, it's possible to use this pronoun. Oui, Isabelle joue au tennis. Repeat everything. Second one, oui, elle joue au tennis. And the last one, oui, elle y joue. All right. So you can see that it's quite short. It's quite short, but it's quite useful because you don't need to repeat all the things that were stated in the question, okay? So remember, as usual, the pronoun should come before the verb, all right? So now we'll see how to construct these sentences with the pronoun Y, but then when you're using this negative form. Okay, est-ce qu'Isabelle joue au tennis? First option, oui, elle y joue. Second, non, elle n'y joue pas. All right, so Negative form should be before the pronoun here. Okay, and then as usual, remember the N followed by a vowel, they don't really get along, so a should go away. So you take it away and you get ni, jou, and after the verb, you put your pa form. Okay? Isabelle est au cinéma? Oui. Elle y est? Non. Elle n'y est pas. Same thing, okay? Négation here before your pronoun, but then a is going away, and then pas after your verb. Okay, so let's see now how you construct it with one verb. Alexandre va au concert? Oui, il y va. Non, il n'y va pas. Okay, so no changes from what we saw previously. Okay, so before your verb, and then here, when you get the negative form, your ne is coming before the pronoun, and then your pa is coming after your verb. Okay? When you get two verbs now. Alexandre va aller au concert? So it looks a bit strange, sorry about that, is going to go at the concert. I know, I know, but it's just to show you how it works, and I don't want to change the sentence, okay? So, oui, il va y aller. Okay, so you can see here now that this pronoun y should be before the second verb, okay? Il va y aller. Negative form, non. Il ne va pas. Okay, so your negative form is before and after the first verb. And that's the key thing. Okay, and then your pronoun is coming before your second verb. Okay, so your pronoun I should be always before your second verb. Okay, and now let's see how it will work if we've got composed tense like aller here, and it's at the passé composé form. So Alexandre est allé au concert. Okay, it's the past tense. Oui, il y est allé. Okay, so keep in mind that even if you've got two parts here, okay, it's only one verb. It's the verb aller at the passé composé, okay? So it's composed. So we've got two elements, but still it's one verb. So it means that your pronoun Y should be before. Il, y, est, allé. Alright? And then the tricky thing, normally it's the negative form at the passé composé. Look, non, il. So you put first the negative part. So ne. Obviously, this E is going away because you've got a vowel, okay, as usual. Il n'y est. And then you put, as we saw previously in Unit 5, or I don't remember, I guess it was Unit 5 when I introduced the passé composé, you put this pas here between être and your participe passé form, okay? So, non, il n'y est pas allé. All right. I hope it was clear. Well, we'll do a break right now, but then I'm coming back quite soon for Unité 7, okay? But then if you want to check the previous lessons, they are here, and then the next lessons will come, but not today, okay? But it's youtube.com/imagier, and then the website is here, imagier.net, and it's waiting for you. Have a great day. Bye-bye.